And the picnic can happen right now in this very moment. We are sitting here. Are we there to do something? We have nothing to do. We just enjoy our sitting with no worries. Because sitting is a pleasure. Sitting and listening to someone speaking is a pleasure. You don't need to learn anything. You don't need to pass an exam to get a diploma. You just sit there and enjoy breathing in and out and listen to someone speaking about peace. It is not our intention to give you ideas about peace. You have got plenty of ideas about peace. Our intention is to be peace in the right, in the here and the now. To be peace in the here and the now, not to talk about peace. And this is possible because peace should be there in your body, in your feelings, in your perceptions, in your consciousness. You have your body. Your body might not be in peace. And you learn how to bring peace to our body right here, right in the now. We know that our body suffers. There is a tension. There is a stress. There is a pressure. There is a pain within our body. We have worked our body too hard. Our body has been exposed to a lot of pressure. We don't feel good within our body. There is a conflict, there are many conflicts within our body. The way we handle our body has made our body suffer so much. There is no real peace in our body. So what to do in order to bring peace to our body? This is what we try to do. And we don't need a lot of time to do it. To allow your body to rest, to allow your body to have a chance to renew itself, to heal itself. That is something possible. You can do it today. And after 1 or 2 hours, we feel much better. We are not talking about peace to our body, we are bringing peace to it. And we have our feelings. We might feel sad, we might feel painful, we might feel excited. There are a lot of feelings going on in us, like a river of feelings. There are unpleasant feelings, painful feelings, there are exciting feelings and so on. And there is no peace in our feeling. And you have to learn how to bring peace to our feelings. And this can be done now. You don't need a lot of theory. And we can enjoy doing it, bringing peace to our feelings right here and right now. Our time together is very precious. We don't talk about peace. We try to make peace a reality right here, right now, within our body, within our feelings. And we have also our emotions. Like anger, like fear, like despair. And we don't know how to handle. And every time anger come up, every time fear overwhelms us, Every time despair overwhelms us, we suffer. We don't know what to do in order to be free from them. Being here in Plum Village, together with other friends who know how to handle our feelings and our emotions, we learn how to handle our emotions as well. And with 15 minutes of learning and practice, we begin to know how to handle our fear, how to handle our emotion, our despair, and how to handle our anger. This is very important. And if you cannot handle your fear, your anger, your despair, you cannot talk about peace. If you don't know how to handle your body and your feeling, you cannot talk about peace. Those who handle them well will bring peace, harmony into your body, into your feelings, into your emotions. And then we have our perceptions. Our perceptions are the ground for our action, and they bring forth our feelings, our emotions. We perceive things, but because we are not calm, we are not lucid, we are overwhelmed with our fear, our anger, our despair. That is why we do not perceive things as they are. We have wrong perceptions. We have wrong perceptions on who we are, on who they are, and what is the world. We have a wrong perception concerning ourselves, concerning them, and concerning our situation. And these wrong perceptions are the foundation for all action that will bring unhappiness, destruction, and fear and anger. And that is why we should be able to handle our perceptions, to see whether that perception is a wrong one or a right perception. Most of our suffering comes from our wrong perceptions. That is why we should have the time to consider, to look deeply into the nature of our perceptions in order not to be caught in them, by them, because perceptions are the foundation of all feelings, emotions, afflictions, and so on. The fact is that in our daily life, we are very seldom free of these feelings and perceptions and mental formations. We are rarely ourselves. We are a victim of our feelings, of our perceptions, of our wrong, of our emotions. And we are like something, a leaf floating on the ocean, and the waves push us. We don't have our own sovereignty over the situation. We allow ourselves to be carried away, pulled away by our feelings, our perceptions, and our mental formations, our wrong perceptions. And that is why it's very important to come home to ourselves and master the situation and be the master of ourselves. We do not live our own life. We allow our life to be lived by the circumstances around us. And we have been victim of what is happening. We can rarely be ourselves and become master of our situation. Therefore, it's very important to go home to ourselves